Well, good Monday morning to you folks. Hopefully you had a good night's rest. Hopefully you had a good weekend. You're ready to face the day. Teresa and I were able to get away last week and for about 3 days, spent some time in Myrtle Beach, North Myrtle, Little River area. Got to see some friends and loved ones and send all this devotion out to them today, if you're watching. To those that we didn't get to spend much time with, and even to those that we didn't get to spend any time with. If you watch this, we love you. If it's our intention to someday come back and be able to see everyone, but I know that's an impossibility, right? Chapter 26, of the book of Matthew. All week, we'll be speaking from the Gospels about the crucifixion of Christ, of course. Here we are in the upper room with Jesus and his disciples. And it's been prepared, and there he is. He's ready to eat the Passover with them. In verse 20, "Now, when the even was come, he sat down with the 12. And as they did eat, he said, Verily I say unto you that one of you shall betray me. And they were exceeding sorrowful, and began every one of them to say unto him, Lord, is it I? And he answered and said, He that dippeth his hand with me in the dish, the same shall betray me. The Son of Man goeth as it is written of him. But woe unto that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It had been good for that man if he had not been born. Then Judas, which betrayed him, answered and said, Master, is it I? He said unto him, Thou hast said. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed, and he brake it, and he gave to the disciples, and said, Take, eat, this is my body. And he took the cup, and gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it with you in my Father's kingdom." I don't know about you, but it's heartbreaking stories here leading up to the crucifixion. These are men that put their hope and their trust, of course, in Christ. But I believe he knew better than to put his hope and his trust in them. I believe that he knew, he saw they were only human, and they could believe as much as they could believe. And things would change after their conversion, of course. The Holy Spirit would come, would abide in them like he does us and live in us and give you the ability to be a new creature. But they were walking by sight. And not by faith, but then the one that betrayed him. I like this song. It makes us stop and think, and the listener hopefully to stop and think. If you've never accepted Christ, then you are the one that is crucifying him. We know Judas sold him for 30 pieces of silver, and it is said that there are those that sell him for less. Whatever it is that you choose to put before the Lord, you've made yourself a rich man, and it's going to be hard for you to enter into the kingdom of God. And it'd be impossible without the salvation that comes from Christ, of course. Maybe you are among the crowd, crucify the Savior. Maybe you weren't the one who spat upon his face when the nails were driven in, the pierced the flesh so tender. Maybe you weren't the one who held his precious hands and feet in place. Maybe you weren't around when they cried, "Behold, the King of Kings." Maybe you weren't the one who pierced his side, but in vain, when to his call you answered no. It's you and you alone. The crucified Savior once again. Once again in Pilate's home, Jesus stands before them all. And he bears your load of guilt, your shame, your sin. What you thought was just denial, that's the end of his trial. You've just crucified Savior once again. Once again in Pilate's home, Jesus stands before them all, and he bears your load of guilt, your shame, your sin. What you thought was just denial, that's the end of his trial. You just crucified the Savior once again. There's no way for us to express how much we thank you and love you for laying your life down for us. We pray that you would bless those who have not seen and do not know yet to come to a realization that they need you before it's too late. We love you, Lord, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, folks. See you Tuesday.